Thank you very much. I'll talk a little more as the program goes on, but that song, the Skyboat Song, is an old Scottish song that many of you might have heard before. I am Annie Jewell. If you didn't know who you're entrusting your daughters with every Tuesday night, it's me, I'm Annie Jewell. I, 2 years ago, finished my master's degree in conducting from the University of St. Andrews in Scotland, and this was a song that we did very often in the choral department. They sang it at my graduation and everything, and I've always wanted to direct it myself, and so these girls have been very flexible with me and with my crazy ideas and wanting to do things like that, and so that's Skyboat Song. And as far as I know, the Girls Choir has never done that arrangement of it. But you will know if you look at your programs, our theme today is songs old and new. And so it wouldn't be the Girls Choir if I didn't also include some John Rutter. I myself was in Girls Choir for 10 years, and we would always joke every concert, like, okay, what's our Rutter gonna be this semester? We are going to now sing All Things Bright and Beautiful, which is a John Rutter arrangement.
Thank you.
Thank you. This next piece is actually an original written by my father, who is in the audience here today, and transcribed and arranged by Stephen Arante, the Wilmington Symphony conductor and the previous pianist for the Girls Choir. So enjoy a Kelly Jewell original.
Feeling bad and no one's around, you can't get to
Thank you very much. We are now, weirdly, in the latter half of our program, and I would like to honor some of the girls who will be leaving us. They are sadly, but we're happy for them, but we're also really sad, going on, graduating, going to bigger and better musical things. So for her farewell song, gosh, this is really sad. Lucy is going to sing Danza Danza, Fanciulla Gentile, and she is going to the School of the Arts to finish out high school. Isn't that right? Am I lying? Okay, yes. So welcome, Lucy. Next up are two graduating seniors, Julia Bradford and Emily Taylor. I don't know what in the world we're gonna do without these girls, but we're proud of them, and they're going to sing a song with Emily playing the guitar. Give my mom's fingers a little bit of a break.
Love is the emotions, because being part of Girls Choir is being part of a family. And I have been with these girls for quite some time now, so I just want to say that this, for me, this is one of the bigger graduation moments that we've had in the time period that I've been here. And so forgive me if I cry while I'm doing this. So I'm going to start with Lucy. Come on up, Lucy. Lucy. To me, I'm leaving. And I was like, what? Like, no, you can't leave me. And she said, I'm going to the School of the Arts. I got into the School of the Arts. And I was so excited for her, because that is such an amazing opportunity. And so, of course, even though she's not a senior and graduating from high school, this is a big, big moment. And she is graduating us from us. I'm moving on to something truly amazing. So if you will help me recognize beautiful Lucy and send her off to the School of the Arts to be amazing and to tell us all about it when she comes back, I would appreciate you joining us. She is moving on to NC State to study engineering. You will find her occasionally drafting things because she has ideas already. And she is the queen of Science Olympiad, I hear, just doing really, really well at Science Olympiad. So among all the things that she does, she also contributes to us musically. And Emily, we are really, really excited for you and for your future. She was in the girls' choir, because her mom and I used to work together. I knew her when she was little and used to run around and cause havoc at the bank. And her mom said, I think she's really musical. And I said, oh, she should do that girls' choir thing. And she did, and she has blown it away, folks. Julia is incredibly talented. You see her here on our stage singing beautifully. But this isn't the only musical thing that she does. She plays quite a few instruments. She plays the piano. She plays the flute. And she plays with the youth symphony as well. So I just want to say that this is a very talented young lady who's going on to App State, if I remember, App State, to pursue music, among other things. I'm really excited for the human being that Julia has become, and I know everyone here is proud as well. We are proud of you, and we wish you all the best at college. Although we've recognized some amazing ones today. I want to make sure that I take a moment to thank the people that are involved in making this organization a success. So first off, an enormous thank you to you, parents and loved ones, who have taken the time to come out here today and to get your kids to rehearsal every week on Tuesdays. Thank you so much. Volunteers, our parent volunteers, we literally could not make this happen without you. There are people often driving all over town to make things happen, and I really, really appreciate it. I'd like to thank our parent volunteers and also our volunteer board of directors. So if you are one of those folks, if you could take a moment and stand for me, please. Facility to St. Matthew's Evangelical Lutheran Church. Not only have they've been gracious over many years of allowing us to perform in this facility, but they are offering us the rehearsal space for free every Tuesday. They don't charge us. They do this out of the goodness of their heart and their service to our community, and it is incredibly meaningful that they would make sure that this type of thing can happen. And so an enormous thank you to St. Matthew's Evangelical Lutheran Church and their staff. We appreciate it. It goes without saying, in order to make something important like this happen, we need the support of all of our friends and family, not only with their time and their efforts, but also monetarily. So I'm here to thank you for those of you who took the time to make a donation at the door, even though this is a free concert. I'd like to direct you to the fabulous QR code in the back of our program. If you feel so moved as to find a reason to join us by contributing to Girls Choir of Wilmington, we would love for you to use this to donate online. It does direct you straight into the spot on our website that takes donations. Of course, we'll still have our baskets at the end of the performance if you have extra cash left over. I mean, hey, why not? And then I would also like to point out that this will also get you to our website. So if you are discovering that you are so inspired by this that you too, as a young person, would like to come and perform with us, or you know friends and young people that you think would be amazing in our group, we would hope that you would share with us what we're doing and ask them to join us to audition in the fall. Our auditions will take place on September 5th, which will be our first Tuesday back in this space. Lastly, an enormous thank you to Julia Jewell, who has taken her time to be our accompanist.
Gina, y'all, I'm a simple musician. I really enjoy flapping my arms in front of a choir and singing my little songs. I am not good with all of the scheduling and the sending out emails and making sure people are wearing the right clothes and show up at the right door at the right time. That is not me. That is Gina Gilb. She is a fantastic president. And that is Gina, and that is also the entire board. They pick up way more slack than I would like to admit in front of a room full of people. So thank you to our board. I would also just like to thank my mom, my accompanist. This is so cool to me. Some of you know me, some of you don't, but this is my first time directing a choir in which my mom gets to be my accompanist, and that is the coolest blessing in the world, to be able to have this sort of family dynamic, to sort of be able to look at each other and she knows that what I'm about to say before I even say it, it's perfect. So thank you to her, thank you to everyone, and thank you to the girls for all of their just fantastic hard work. When I'm scatterbrained, when I come in after a long day and I'm like, you know, I kind of just want to be curled up in a little ball right now, but instead we're going to sing some songs. They humor me, and they do it beautifully. So thank you. If you're in charge of these people, you've done an excellent job. So thank you all so much. We have one more piece.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you all so much again for coming. It is a long time Girls Choir tradition to invite our alumni up to the stage to sing the Irish Blessing. If you are an alum of the Girls Choir, please come up now and join us.